What's going on, everybody? My name's Chris, and welcome to Let's Play SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom. If you didn't watch my last episode because it was like a question mark Let's Play, I'm like, what the heck is this? I'm not watching this. Go watch it. Is this your first episode watching of this game? Give it a chance because this is actually a fantastic game. I know it's SpongeBob, but it's actually great. Anyways, in the last episode, we wished that we could play with real robots. And then that was a whole bunch of robot. There's a robot invasion, and it's freaking scary and sucks. In this episode, we're actually going to start by exploring Bikini Bottom and see if we can maybe get to the first level of the game. But for now, let's start by destroying all the tikis. Like I said, star bits are very... See, there you go again! Last episode, I kept calling these things star bits, and yeah, that's still a thing. There is a border here. However, as you see, you actually need 15 golden spatulas to continue exploring. This is the Roblox. Patrick over here, let's see what he wants.
Patrick. Nice sock.
I agree.
What sock?
The one you're standing on.
Patrick's voice actor is different too.
That one.
Or is it?
It's lost.
Oh.
Well, if
lost
that
sock.
One's lost, where are your other socks?
Well, they're more lost.
Uh-oh.
A bunch of robots came through here and stole my whole sock collection.
How dare
I could
they?
Use some help getting them back.
How
sure
dare
thing,
they?
Patrick. What are best friends for?
Okay then. For every 10 socks you bring back to me, I'll give you a golden turkey baster.
Aw, great. I need to do all the turkeys up. Okay, there we go. Like he said, for every 10 socks you bring him, he will give you a spatula. I believe there's 100 socks in total in the game. We can jump up this here. Oh. Hey, it's Bubble Buddy.
Give you a bubble hand.
Bubble Buddy.
You see,
bubble
you're
buddy!
Going to need to learn some new bubble-blowing moves if you're going to journey to the ninth dimension and defeat the giant monkey man.
Whoa!
But
you gotta do that?
All I need to do is figure out how to get rid of these robots.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I've been in the soap bottle a little too long. Where were we?
Something about new bubble moves.
Right! Press this button and you'll launch yourself straight up in the air.
Okay, so they just explain, yeah, press Y, exact same thing they did explain in the house. There's quite a long tutorial in this game, but it's really not too bad, all things considered. Like, they don't tell you things over and over again, they don't hold your hand.
This robot crisis is making the Krusty Krab lose money like a sinking ship. No money means no more Krusty Krab. No more Krusty Krab means no more fry cooking for you.
I don't know how many of the voice actors are different in this game, and they're just good with impressions. But Mr. Krabs' voice is the only one I have problems with in this entire game.
And of course, make a small profit in return. I've got a few golden spatulas that I'll be willing to trade to you for some of those shiny objects.
Doesn't it just sound like he's trying too hard?
I don't know. What are employers for? Besides, them shiny objects is worth lots of money. Your treasure chest's looking a bit light, boy. Do you think I've got bilge water on the brain? I ain't running a charity here.
I gotta get used to voice acting again because. We need 3,000 shiny objects for the first spatula. That's the main use of shiny objects in this game, buying objects from Mr. Krabs, but you can also use shiny objects to get farther to bonus areas of a level. Let's actually continue looking through here before going into Squidward's or Patrick's house here. But, shiny objects in this game could be used to progress in a level, get bonus content in a level, or also buy golden spatulas. This is a 100% run, so I'm gonna need a whole bunch of shiny objects, and holy crap, I'm not looking forward to getting all the shiny objects, since at one point I am gonna need, like, over 1.5 million shiny objects, I believe. So that is not gonna be the most fun thing to do, because there's no way I'm gonna be able to get that on my first playthrough. So yeah, right there, we hit another button by pressing jump and then using X to butt stomp or bubble stomp or whatever you would call it in this game. And then we hit this switch, and that starts a timer. So these platforms are based on a timer when the other one over here is not. That is based on a timer. That's weird that doesn't come up. Or that there's a cutscene. Oh, okay. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Alright. So if we just gotta wait around. Waiting around town. Okay. And here we go. This is actually a golden pair of underwear. As you can see, we went from having 3 health to now we have 4. And if we jump on top of here, we get that golden spatula! Woo! And SpongeBob's roof looks really weird. He has like a little... I know this is supposed to be a trap door, at least in the show. So So, but it looks really weird there. I guess that's supposed to be like a stem. There's no reason to ever go back in SpongeBob's house ever. We might eventually. Gary's in there. Good boy, Gary. Actually, Gary does show up a lot in this game. The only person that's weird that kind of shows up in this game is Bubble Buddy. I almost called him Bubble Boy. Like, he's not a main character, but for some reason he is now, at least in this game. Okay, let's enter Squidward's house and see what's going on with him.
Ruined a perfectly relaxing mud bath this morning, and now you
mud bath.
Can my day get any more dreary?
You're a squid, not a freaking.
I am so sorry, Squidward. Patrick and I were just
not a freaking hippopotamus.
Oh, I correct myself. I should have known that whole robot problem involved both of you.
Don't even say that, bro. Oh, look, the I and I should is also not capitalized.
Squidward,
I guess that's just the font.
How can I fix everything?
That's weird to me. You can't. No, you guys are capitalized.
That should help out more than enough. Move to another town. I cracked me up. But seriously, just jump around like an idiot. That should at least make me smile.
Oh, be careful what you wish for, Squidward. Should be very careful. So, like he said, we destroy everything! And by everything, I mean most things. What? Graffiti! That's actually pretty mean of us, but, you know, whoa. Why is that picture floating? What the? Is this one floating too? No, that's against the wall. Look at that! It's the curse of the mysteriously floating picture frame! This one is... no, that's not floating, that's against the wall. So, yeah, he gives us a hint that we should destroy all the things. Ugh, destroy his heads! There we go. And for doing all that, we get a golden sock. Yay! There's a picture of sea-bound Squidward over here. Cat and Squidward tentacles. Angry Squidward.
Okay, just stop jumping, will you?
What? Oh!
This golden spatula.
I didn't actually know that.
Please go away.
See, Squidward? I knew that you could help me out. You're the best.
He is. I actually forgot about that. I just thought you got a golden sock in here, or a sock rather, but no, you actually get a golden spatula if you actually jump around enough. Interesting. Can we not get this? I don't think we get this. Ugh. Probably destroy my foothold. Oh well. There are different values for the shiny objects. The red ones are 1, gold is 5, blue is 10, I think. Purple is 50. And I think there's maybe 100 in this game. And see, everything responds once you go back outside. So that's why I kind of want to get all the tikis and all that first, just to show me destroying them all, I suppose. Go also enter Patrick's rock. And that kind of rocks, actually. See what I did there. Destroy the freaking sofa. You get another sock! You would think that maybe it would appear underneath the sofa, but no, it's weird. Wait. Oh yeah, okay, the red ones are indeed 1. Yeah, those are 1. Let's see what I get out of there. I seem to get 2 for every tiki I destroy. Oh, I love playing this music all over the place! Weird, rock is gray from underneath. Okay then, he has the picture in here. It's adorable. Yeah, that's Patrick's house. Fantastic. The house of a genius, ladies and gentlemen. The house of a genius. Alright. Now, I guess with nothing else to do, let's go take on the first level of the game. Oh, Bubble Buddy, calm your face off. There's something. Yeah, that's actually the only level available to us. It is pretty much a huge tutorial level. And yep, the way you travel in this game is taxi, apparently. Who would have freaking thought, figured? I don't know, it's kind of random.
Ah, the rolling green hills of Jellyfish Fields. A place to experience nature at its most raw. And sometimes, a bit tender from the stings.
It's a golden spatula!
How'd you get here so quick, Squidward? He somehow beat me here, even though I just saw him in his house. So yeah, this is our first instance of actually getting to robots.
Squidward, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay, you bastard.
Where'd you get the bandages from?
Do I look like I'm okay?
Well, your nose looks fantastic.
Your nose does look pretty big.
Yeah.
And bigger than usual because it's usually pretty big. And you look clammy. And oh my gosh, you're bald!
Oh, he's bald! I'm so sorry, Squidward.
Now I'm stuck.
Oh, he's
all
always
over.
Been bald.
Well, according to the Jellyfish Field Manual, severe jellyfish stings can be treated effectively by applying a thick layer of king jellyfish jelly to the affected areas. King jellyfish?
Well, I guess you're off to scale Spork Mountain and die a horrible death under the vicious tentacles of King Jellyfish.
Well, if you laugh
I'll
at me.
Stay here, balled up here in excruciating pain.
What? Why would he laugh at me when he's asking me for a favor?
Don't worry, Squidward. I'll bring back that
like,
king
what?
Jellyfish jelly for you to rub all over yourself.
It's not like this is SpongeBob's fault. Well, I mean, it is because he thinks it's his fault that, you know, all the robots are taking over. But Squidward doesn't know that. And yet, you can actually leave the level whenever you want by just coming to the taxi. Also, if you go to bounds, SpongeBob does this, and eventually you'll get grabbed by the hand. And that happens anywhere in the game if you go out of bounds. But alright, so the overview it showed of this level... you might think, oh, that's the entire level. This is kind of like this game's version of, Bomb's Battlefield. But no, this is like 1/4 of the level. There's loading screens in between. This is goo. SpongeBob and Patrick can't swim, so don't let them fall in goo. Yeah, we will be falling actually momentarily. If you look closely, there's actually a sock out there. This is a teleport box. When you have both teleport boxes in the air open, you may teleport in between them by jumping inside. Yep. You have to walk by it and make sure it opens. Always make sure these open. It could definitely be a pain if you think they open and then it turns out they don't.
Can't jellyfish today. I'm going fishing for robots.
Oh, it's a cute little jellyfish. He's so adorable. He's adorable.
You are. Oh, God. Actually, I didn't think he would hit me for a second there. I tried to tempt him to hitting me, but no, he would not. All right.
I feel like a new star.
There's more robots over here. Kill those assholes. These are like them, you know, the basic. There are combos in this game, actually. Which combos are pretty much the best way to rack up. Star chips? Why do I keep on calling them star chips and star bits? These things bounce you really high. A lot higher than you think they would bounce you. But yeah, probably the best way I would say to collecting, collecting shiny objects is by racking up combos by far. Over here, you see that 125. Well, I was going to say that's our first instance of where we have to use shiny objects to pay for our way through, but no, that's not even true. We've already done that a few times. Oh, okay, let's not fall in the water. I was going to destroy those tickets. I'm like, what's the point? There's really no point to it. If we go over here, actually, well, first off, I'll show you guys more of the combos. There we go. See, it went from combo to super combo to ultra combo. That's just an example of the many combos. Maybe the biggest combo is like super ultra mega monster combo or something like that. Okay, I'm glad there's only a pair of underwear up there. And here's our first somewhat secret, I guess. I don't want to call it that. So mega combo, monster combo, super monster combo. Oh god. See, listen to how loud that. I'm gonna have to turn that down because that is a massive. Like, that is way too weirdly loud. And it's. I get it's a waterfall and it's supposed to be loud, but that's like blown out speakers loud and. I don't know. That's one of my qualms with this game, is that they really should have tested that a bit more. If we come over here, we can paint this clam. 125 shiny objects. Whoa! Where did that even fall out? The plane didn't open up. Where did the plane go? Where did the plane? Oh, it's gone. Oh no. If you ever want to know... Oh, yep, that's a checkpoint if you ever die. Although the checkpoints don't really seem to do much, since if you do die before an area and you don't get a checkpoint, it'll spawn you in a different place, which is really weird. It's like you'd think they would just have checkpoints all over the place, like when you get to new areas, but no. New areas count as their own checkpoints, which is weird. If you go into the start menu, you'll see I have 1 out of 14 socks. That's just in this area. So if you go into the next areas, you see 0, 11, 0, 9, etc, etc. Alright. Finding socks in most of the areas in the game has been very difficult for me, especially this area in particular. The very beginning part of the game is actually one of the hardest area portions of the game, to 100% I've noticed. Can we get up here, please? No? Oh, really? What's up there? Okay, it's just a pair of underwear. Alright, what's this over here? This looks very peculiar. Ooh, shiny object. This is a Freezy Fruit. Only Patrick can use Freezy Fruit. Yeah. Only Patrick. Does that mean we'll be playing as Patrick later? There's that sock over there. See, there's Freezy Fruit here and that sock over there. That kind of hints towards one of the ways to get that sock. I'm about to show you the other way, actually. You can actually... Well, I don't know if this was intentional or not. I feel like it wasn't. Like, at least it wasn't supposed to be, but it's... Obviously is, because it just kind of works out. But if we go up here, collect all those shiny objects, and if we time this out decently enough, we could actually get the sock. We do die, and that's what happens when you go into the goo. But we do, when we do die, when we get sent back to the checkpoint, we don't lose everything we got before the checkpoint. We actually, if you look back over there, the sock's gone. Yep, we kept it. You can suicide mission for items you want in this game. That's definitely very useful to gain stuff like that. So, the other way to get that is obviously using a Freezy Fruit Patrick, but we have not played as Patrick yet. Maybe that'll happen eventually. Maybe not. We shall see. I mean, it's clearly going to happen, but, you know, I got to keep some mystery in this game. Okay. I got to keep looking around to make sure I'm not missing anything here, because I definitely feel like I'm going to. If we jump up here. Ooh. We jump over. Oh, I didn't make it. Nice. Nothing down there, is there? It doesn't look to be. Unless there's... Nope. There are no star bits down there. Alright, here's another switch. They do give you little reminders, like in the bottom there, the text box said, reminder, you can jump and press X, do a butt stomp. Or I guess that's not called that in this game. But, yeah. It's not, like, obnoxious in this game. Like, you can read that if you want. Clearly you don't need to, though. Ah, here's our first instance of a purple shiny object. See, let's get the blue here. 48. Yeah, see that? Oh, that gives me 10. Yeah, there we go. And the purple gave me 50. Alright, jump on there. Yeah. Those trampolines can be random sometimes. Sometimes they can be massive and, like, push you super far away where you wouldn't expect them to push you. But other times they can just, like, push you a tiny... Or they can jump you a little bit. So be wary of that. Always be sure you know where you're going to be going with those. Alright. Nothing really over here. Some robots down there. Really wrong. Ah, it's Spiky Pufferfish. Mrs. Puff! Oh my god, what did they do to you? Mrs. Puff! Oh god! Oh, well. I think there's underwear over here. This game does get super difficult later on. Can destroy this. To everything in this game. Bacon shaken? Wow, oh, I kind of skipped that a bit. See, like, listen, you can barely hear what they're saying because of the waterfall. Yeah, so Gary pointed over here. There's a bungee jump hook. Spongebob can bungee from it. Yep. All you gotta do is jump into it and you automatically latch on. So you can't really reach. You can press A to dive. You can actually spam A. If you look closely, you can see SpongeBob butt crack. Oh my god, the butt quack. And you press B to quit. Alright. There we go. We got a golden spatula. Yay! Okay, we're going to move away from here. Then we're going to end off the episode. Okay, there we go. Okay. So in the next episode, we'll continue down Jellyfish Fields and see how far we can get. We have seemed to reach an area where we cannot... What? Why is there a shiny object down there? Do you see that, guys? That's obviously in a pit of doom. I don't get why that's there. Okay, well, anyways. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe already. If you've been watching so far, thank you very much for giving this game a shot. It does... Like, even this has been pretty good so far, but it does get even better. Like I said, this is just a tutorial level still. So once we're going through this level, it will ramp up. The difficulty will ramp up. And there'll be a lot more challenges for us to come. So, till next time, I'll see you guys later. Peace.